Who are you to sit in judgment on me, McPhee? And he played 151 games, not one of them was worth a pinch of poop. Hacks! Deadbeats, a lot of yous.
Well, that's lovely. A player threatens the president of the club with physical violence and nobody says a word.
Oh, shut up, Ted.
You're lucky he didn't play for you. You gotta be bloody tactful when a player's getting on in years. You gotta play the game yourself, you'd know. I remember Tubby Roberts took me apart in the 39 grand final. When I got home, Dulcie says to me, I think you met your match today. So I thumped her one. She apologized later, but by then the damage was done.
What are you studying, Jeff?
Economics.
Well, I don't know whether I hold with young blokes going to university. Put some funny ideas in their head. Not going to interfere with your football, is it?
Oh, this is bloody lovely. We're playing us over here at more expense than importing the entire bloody Moscow State Circus, and you can't even get
on good. We didn't know the kid was pulling something like this.
Knowing you, Frank, you probably put him up to it. Well, the business is if you can't deliver the goods, and don't try and
shut up. I'm warning you, shut up!
Calm down!
I was the coach of this club myself for 15 years. I know talent when I see it. Sorry, I'm late. What are you doing there? Strike? Right, strike. I never heard anything like it in my life. Who's involved? Give me their names. No one's going to hold this club to ransom. I'll suspend a lot of you. Who else is involved? This is a disgusting and a despicable threat, Danny. I played 282 games for this club. And every time I ran out onto that ground, I felt as honored to be out there wearing the club colours as I did the
Calm
first
down,
time.
Jock.
God, I never thought I'd live to see the day when I'd hear the word strike uttered in this room. Look at them pictures up there, Danny. Danny, I'm talking to you.
And he played 151 games. Not one of them was worth a pinch of poop. Hacks! Deadbeats, a lot of yous.
You know what I want to do? I want to turn every one of them pictures around so they don't have to look down on this whole shameful scene. How would Harry Payne feel if he knew that the word strike was being bandied around in this hallowed room? Be surprised if he's turning in his grave right now.
He isn't even dead.
Harry? I went to his funeral last year.
That was Harry Treloar.
Shit, yeah. Well, there's so many of them dropping off, I get confused.
Calm down!
Danny, you've given the club great service, and only a fool would deny it.
Oh, he's allowed to call me a drunk. I'm not allowed to tell him he's played a bad game.
Shut up, Tedder, I'll thump you.
Yes, but
think about your papers.
You've come good.
We do have a problem with him, Jock, you know? He's openly defying Laurie to the point of coming to blows.
Well, you could have told me that, Laurie. No sin to have one of your men play up on you. You ought to know that. I have to lay you out behind the lockers in your first year before I got any sense out of you.
Make the same. Bullshit.
Good chump never hurt anyone.
Now, what are you doing here, Laurie? You know, I've been thinking about that problem you have with young Jeff. Now, I wondered if you tried talking to the lad.
No,
I used to talk to my blokes. No, he's the
player. I had to lay you out behind the lockers in your first year before I got any sense out of you. Good chump never hurt anyone.
Shut up, Cheddar, I'll pump you.
First I've heard of it.
Come on, Jock, I'm not an idiot.
Oh, yeah, well, I did even whisper to that
you
peck.
Don't
now that
you hear whispers, Jock, you startling.
He's been fawning on him like a drunken toad.
That thank Christ is all I can tell me. Let's face it, Laurie, the man's a buffoon. Oh, that Jerry's got some great ideas for next year.
Ted.
Great administrator, that lad.
You were the one man on the committee who voted against his appointment.
Well, man can be wrong.
Not many can manage it as often as you.
Jock's point.
Pick it up!
Is worth considering, though. This is possibly the last year that Danny will command decent money.
I say sell him while he's still worth something. I mean, let's face it, Laurie, but when we were winning our medals, it was in a team full of champions. Danny is little more than a talented hack.
Look at him, Flip. Leaves his wife and kids for some aimless rent-a-car, Sheila. I'll tell you what, Dulcie, none of these players these days have got 1 ounce of moral fibre.
Come off it, Jock. He's bloody near as good as either of us were in our day. I know what's bothering you, mate. If he stays here another year or two, he'll end up beating your precious 282 games.
Yeah, well, you couldn't beat it. He's not going to beat it either.
Oh, Tank!
Where my record goes, it's going to be to someone with a bit of moral fibre.
Hello, here comes the president of Kerry Grant.
This is my friend, Sue.
Ah, hello, Susie, and what do you do?
I study history.
Oh, well, some of us study it, and some of us make it. Look, Jeff, sorry to barge you, don't you like this, but I've got a couple of problems down at the club. Gorgeous looking cheerleader up there, Jeff.
I've been a bit worried about your form,
to tell you the truth, lately, Jeff, and seeing as I was the one who insisted on getting you, I thought we might have a little chat. It's my opinion that the reason that you haven't been playing as well as you're capable is because he hasn't been giving you a fair go. I hear that you two had a bit of an altercation.
Yeah, we did.
Well, any coach that has to resort to them sort of methods is no coach in my life.
I'd delay you out behind the lockers in the first year before I got any sense out of you. It's something I've heard anyway.
Oh, a marvellous high mark you took last Saturday. Jeez, you just seem to go up and up.
Yeah, I felt like Achilles.
Yeah. Who's he?
A Greek guy who could really jump.
Oh, yeah. Well, some of these new Australians. You know, they could be real champions if they forget about soccer and just learn to assimilate. Why did Butcher Malone take a swing at you last Saturday? Did you give him the old elbow in the gut, eh?
No, I blew him a kiss.
Oh, very good. They're very subtle. Well, of course, I was a bit more direct in my day. You know them times when you're half a yard behind your man? He's going for the ball. Now, there's no way in the world you're going to stop him, right? Right. Just as he leaves the ground, get your thumb, ram it up his bum. Oh, it works every time. Oh, you roll your own, do you? Mm. Yeah, I used to roll my own.
Would you like me to roll you one?
Yeah, why not? We'll have a nice little chat and a quiet smoke.
I've got a couple here already to roll.
Oh, beauty. Good on you, son. How many of them do you smoke a day?
Three or four.
No, no problem. You get a bit used to having them filtered. Now, Jeff, this trouble that you're having with Laurie, do you think that's the main problem?
I don't know if I can.
It won't go any further than this room if you do, son. You know that. You probably gathered that me and Laurie don't exactly see eye to eye.
Yeah, I have sensed a bit of friction.
In fact, we hate each other's guts. From the very minute he joined this club, he's made it his business to rewrite the club's history with himself as its biggest shining star. He was obsessed with beating my record of 282 games. Absolutely obsessed. He had a bad groin injury and a dicey hamstring. He was in agony every time he took that ground, but there was no stopping him.
But he didn't beat it.
No. No, he tripped a little rabbit, Rutherford, coming out of the pack and did his cartilages with only three games to go, and I can't say I was sorry. In fact, I laughed me bloody head off. I mean, let's face it, Laurie. Parker's a disgrace to this club. Hitting a woman, what a bloody disgrace.
I wouldn't have thought that anyone who'd given his wife as many black eyes as you have would be quite so self-righteous.
Sometimes you're too smart for your own good, Laurie. You know how he took over from me as coach? He went around to the members of the committee behind my back and told them I was drunk during the 69 grand final. I had a cold in the head. I had a few sips of whiskey, but I was not drunk. He'll keep. He's going to get his. He promised that committee the world. He hasn't even won them one premiership, and I've won four.
I knew what you were about long before that. I saw the last game of football you ever played.
Ah, bullshit. You wouldn't have been out of your cradle.
I was eight. I used to worm my way down to the fence so I could get a better look at the game. What was the name of that bloke you flattened?
You weren't there?
Yes, I was. The whole thing happened about 20 yards from where I was standing. You waited till he started to pick himself up off the ground. Then you went straight in with your knee. He'd have been about 5'7", and he weighed about 10 stone.
He was as badly hurt as the papers made out. Nobody's ever called me a coward before.
Well, I'm calling you one now. And if you're going to be our new president, then this is definitely my last year as coach.
It's going to be your last year anyway, smartass. We're getting ourselves a real coach around here next year, thank Christ. So stick that in your pipe and smoke it. Shut up, Jenner, I'll pump you. Do you really think I'd sabotage this club for 8 years just to get back at you?
Yes, I do.
Then you're crazy.
It's just as well we're getting rid of you.
You can call me what you like, mate.
The record books are going to show that I played 3 more games than you did. And I won 4 more premierships. And they're still going to be saying that in 100 years.
What are you doing helping
us out, Jeff?
I don't want Rostov either.
I got a feeling he's going to play very well for the rest of the season.
Yeah, well, don't count on him. I know something about him that you don't.
What's this stuff you know about Jeff?
He's totally bloody unstable. The first thing we do next year is sell him.
Sell him?
Yeah. He's been up his mum and his legless sister and he thinks he killed his old man.
What?
He confided in me, so don't go saying anything, but... Hey, if he starts playing too good, we can always leak a rumour or two.
Jock. Jeff has 2 brothers, no sisters, and his father had his 54th birthday last week.